guys. So I'm coming to do my first hair video. So I'm super excited about this. What I'm gonna be doing today is I'm gonna do a wash because this stuff is dirty. This was an old twist style I had in my hair. But yeah, this stuff is dirty. So I'm gonna wash it today and I'm gonna style it and I'm gonna let you guys watch as I do it. I've been a natural for 5 years. It wasn't always easy. When I first cut my hair, I was like, what did I do? But now I love it. I love my hair. I'm always playing it. That's probably why I am experiencing so many issues at this moment, because once your hair is cut and you first learn how to style it as it's short, you get used to that. When it gets longer, you're like, oh my gosh, what do I do with this stuff? So it's almost like learning your hair all over again, because I used to keep raising my hair for a really long time and now I don't. So now I'm stuck with learning how to do my hair. And so, which is not a bad thing because I love doing different styles of my hair. So I'm gonna wash it. I'm gonna be using Shea Moisture. I don't know if you guys can see. This is the Black Castor Oil line. It's a Strength and Restore shampoo and conditioner. Perfect. I'll be using these two. And then after I shower or wash it, I'm going to use the leave-in cream. Love, love this stuff. And of course you're gonna need a wide tooth comb. I just really use it for this. Every now and then I detangle my hair. Just depends on what style I'm doing, but I mainly use this just to part my hair. And I got a brush. Brush. Okay, you guys know what a brush looks like. All right, so I also, for gel, I use the Eco Silo gel. So you guys will also see that too. So yeah, let's get in this video. All right guys, so now I am going to wash, and excuse my husband because he's gonna interrupt me at any moment, but I definitely want you guys to see the shampoo process.
I'm making a video. Get out of here.
Babe, do you know how to add this on my iPad right now? What you talking about? You gotta edit it.
Alright guys, so you just saw me wash my hair. Now I'm getting ready to condition it. I like to take my time and do this section.
Michael.
So this will be a while. I divide it in half at first, and then I do my four sections. Just doing a little bit of finger detangling here and there, but making sure I get a lot of product on my hair. I like this conditioner because it kind of glides through my hair pretty well, so I don't have to do a lot of detangling. Okay, and also excuse me for my background. I was actually giving my 1 and 2 year old a bath, so you were gonna hear them in the background. But I definitely want you guys to see this process and then see how well I get the product in my hair and I detangle it as well.
Thank you.
washed my hair. Now it's time to style. So usually I don't know what I'm gonna do with my hair. So what I start out doing first is I always just moisturize it until something pops up in my head and I'm like, oh, I'll do that. Okay, so I start off by sectioning in half. Like I said, with this too, I mean, sometimes it depends on where I'm going or if I'm going anywhere, how I moisturize, but mostly I use this leave-in conditioner I showed you guys earlier. Show you again. I use that and I just take some of it and just glob it in my hair pretty much. You guys see me? Okay. I just glob it everywhere. Not even section it. And glob some more in each section just to make sure I moisturize every little part of my hair. Now, also, if I do have a style in mind, I will detangle if necessary. But today, I have somewhere to go. And detangling just takes forever. So I'm gonna do a little bit of finger here and there, but overall, I am not going to detangle. Okay? So I'll just twist this side and go to my next section. So my whole head is done. Get in there. All right. Same thing, glob, 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 part, glob some more, a little bit of finger action, okay, that's good. Section my hair, you guys can see. Okay, and the part is going all the way in the back. So I sectioned it. Okay, so now this one side is fully moisturized. And I think I'm just gonna only use half of it. So, take my part down to my ear. And yeah, so about, you guys can see that. Okay, and I'm gonna section this side and back. Okay, now I am going to just get my ends. A little bit of a comb there. There we go. Because I think I'm just going to do twist up front, twist in back. Oh, yeah. So like I said, I have somewhere to go this morning, so don't have much time.
Of your hair together, and then whatever style you choose to use. And here, and in this section right here, you're going to add a little bit of gel in the back, and then I'm going to use my hair tie. After I add gel to the back of my head, I'm using my hair tie to bring it all together. And it's kind of a two-in-one. You can either use your hair tie to high bun. And you'll see that now. Okay, so now you'll see me fluffing it. Like I said, the lower bun. Just fluff it to however you like it to be. Just because my hair is still not where I want it to be, I don't usually wear this style because you can see all these little stringies in the back. I don't like that look. So I actually chose to raise the bun all the way to the top of my head to avoid seeing all those little stringies in the back. When I'm done, I usually use a scarf to tie it on my head, but at this time I was recording at my mother-in-law's house, so I didn't have it with me. I usually put on this scarf for like 20 or 30 minutes before I leave, but as I said before, I was in a rush to go anyway, so if I did have my scarf, I wouldn't have used it. But yeah, this is the end of it, guys, so if you like it, definitely like that like and subscribe.